the void, but somehow different this time.
Surprised I can pull you into this place? The outsider marked me long ago. I made you flee your precious tower and turned your father into cold stone. How difficult for you. But when I was young, sweet Jessamine and I were closest sisters, sharing a secret. Emperor Caldwin had another daughter, born in shame to a kitchen maid.
Am I dreaming? If not, how is Delilah doing this?
I told you, when you're older, perhaps next year.
You said that last year. Jessamine is younger than me, and she's a court every day.
Distance? Well, it's complicated. You understand someday.
What did I do? I'll be good, I swear.
Next year, I promise.
Games in the tower, but at night I'd go back to the servants' quarters to cockroaches and thin gruel. Emperor Daddy would visit and tell me if I was good. Next year I'd be old enough to come to court to be a princess. Then one day, pretty Jessamine broke something worth a fortune, and the spymaster caught us. She claimed I did it, and he whipped me in the garden house until I bled. My mother lost her kitchen job, and that night we were out on the streets with no place to sleep.
I didn't forget.
Would you like to tell me what
we did? We weren't just playing.
Never mind, Jessamine. What's your account?
It was her. Delilah's lie. She broke it.
Saw the nastiest parts of Dunwall, ending up in debtor's prison. Jessamine died quick on an assassin's blade, but my mother lingered for weeks after a fat guard broke her jaw. They threw me out when she died. I looked up at the lights of Dunwall Tower and swore revenge. Washing bedsheets in a brothel, I painted on the side, until Anton Sokolov took me as a student. That's the polite word for it. I was crafty even before the outsider marked me, and survived the worst the Empire could offer. Now, it's your turn.
My mother's sick. She needs help.
Your mother kicked off while you were out begging. She's another bag of bones now, girl.
What? No!
Your sentence is served and you'll be tossed out with the others. You can't stay here anymore.
It's hard to know whether my dear old aunt is telling the truth or not. When I saw what they'd done to Anton Sokolov, I wanted to hurt everyone who'd helped Delilah and the Duke of Sirkonos pull off their coup. Sokolov is the man who made whale oil into a weapon, who turned back the plague, and now he's barely able to speak. The hands that painted the most powerful men and women of our time shake too badly to hold a spoon. When he does talk, he's going to give me a name. The next step along the way to Duke Luca Abel, then Delilah herself. A name. That's all I need. Wasn't a dream, was it?
Am I to blame for Delilah's bitterness?
All this is her doing, and she'll die for it.
Our decisions have weight. I feel my time drawing to an end. Soon.
any different had I not passed from the world.
It would have enabled him to make his clockwork
soldiers. Delilah Copperspoon, or is it Caldwin?
Clever man. Not clever enough. What's wrong with people like that?
A restless mind and an empty heart, perhaps. Jindosh would have snuffed me out as soon as he got bored. I appreciate what Emily did for me, freeing me from that place.
I searched for you, Anton.
One of the more elaborate structures in Karnaca, closed to the public. More of the Duke's questionable rulership.
Either way, you're back now. I'm glad.
Ah, the Empress has risen.
Anton, you've had 3 days to rest. Tell me how to kill Delilah.
They tortured him. His body is covered with bruises.
Delilah has the throne, and my father is missing. This is Anton Sokolov, the greatest mind in the Empire.
No, Emily. Megan is right. I can make electricity move from one side of the room to the other, but Delilah is beyond my understanding. When I came to Sir Konos, I meant to leave everything behind. But when the assassination started, I couldn't ignore it. By the time Megan and I connected the murders to the Duke, it was too late. The Crown Killer came for me. It kept me alive from my knowledge, but I saw things. Jindosh often had a visitor, Brianna Ashworth.
She's the curator of the Royal Conservatory.
Yes, Ashworth is dangerous, as obsessed with the occult as Delilah. Apparently, she's working on a device called the Oraculum.
There's more to her than either of you know.
If Ashworth is one of Delilah's lieutenants, I need to eliminate her. Who knows what this device is capable of, or what she's up to?
For a man of his age, Sokolov's making better progress than I would have expected.
Good to see you're still with us. Thank you for helping, Anton.
Sokolov's not the only one making a rapid recovery. I'll be good enough to leave soon. There's a lot to do. Of course, unless the Duke falls, he'll undo my best efforts here.
Then we'll have to make sure Duke Luca Abel doesn't overstay his welcome.
Karnaca's key leaders are flawed, for certain. After all this is settled with the Duke, and the time of the coup has passed. Whichever ones are left standing could change things here. Consider that, as you come face to face with the Duke's remaining associates.
Some of them have made their beds, Alexandria.
Take the skiff. I don't want to bring the dreadful whale any closer than we have to. There is a small dock in Syria Gardens, close to the conservatory. That's as far as I can take you. Ready to go?
Yes, let's go.
There'll be a grand guard presence outside the Royal Conservatory. Inside, be prepared for anything. Ashworth runs with an eclectic crowd. They'll be the real danger.
Someday I'd like to know more about how you met Ashworth.
I know you would. Trust me. Ashworth is important to Delilah. Which brings up something else. You might be able to exploit the Abbey of the Everyman in removing Ashworth from play. Turns out the Vice Overseer in Karnaca has been watching Ashworth from a hidden outpost near the Royal Conservatory. Check it out first if you want more options. Remember, if she's still working with Delilah, Ashworth is a grave threat.
Thanks, Maggie. See you soon.
Me of good times. But what's the point of buying wood from a country you never visited?
Lady Shersha has money, so she gets the wood she wants.
At the body house, one night, now I'm covered in shankers.
The blood clots are disgusting, you see. And what's next? It's enough to make
me
crazy.
Now they say there's someone.
Your lucky day, madam. It's the day you get to meet Pirate Betty in person. Time to pay the price if you want to live.
Never heard of her. Oh, wait, wasn't she a waitress down on the docks?
You must have heard the stories about Pirate Betty. About all the terrible things I've done to the fools who refuse to give up some trinkets or a bag of coins.
No, I've never heard one word about your exploits, but go on. What did you do to your marks? Give them a good tap on the nose?
For shit's sake, why do you have to ruin everything? I played my part when I was the victim. How are we supposed to attract any suckers if you won't play along?
You're the worst thug I've ever seen. Pirate Betty? My ass. You couldn't scare a seagull.
What a moving, tragic death. You're a far better actress than I am.
It's you and me now.
I was the victim. How are we supposed to attract any suckers if you won't play along?
You're the worst thug I've ever seen. Pirate Betty? My ass. You couldn't scare a seagull.
What a moving, tragic death. You're a far better actress than I am. Look sharp, she says. Stay awake, she says. Not even sure what I'm supposed to be looking for.
Was closed. Greetings. I provide only the
trinkets he sells. Children snatched off the streets, locked in basements with little hope or light.
An acquaintance of mine is supposed to be holed up in an office overlooking the Royal Conservatory. Check on them if you're headed that way. I check myself, but the streets are locked down. I'd make it worth your time.
I'll think about it.
See anything you like? What a pleasant surprise to see you again. This is what I have for upgrading your equipment. No need to wrap it for you, I suppose. I'm certain you will be satisfied with your purchase. Blood flies are worse here than any district in Kanaka.
To be here.
Said it was fine. He looked at the wall of life and climbed up to check the windmill. All good. Why?
Yesterday, the wind kicked up so hard I thought the windmill was gonna fall apart. The wall of light was flickering and sparking like crazy.
I've seen that too. But whale oil's expensive now, and the tanks run dry. The wind's unpredictable.
Look at you, leaving a trail of bloody boot prints across this dying city. Brianna Ashworth would have been miserable as a member of high society, forced to wed some bloated banker. Her only moments of real freedom, getting drunk at fancy balls, and slipping away to couple with strangers. It would have ended in an unhappy marriage and a late-night plunge into an icy river. But just before mother and father married her off, so many years ago, she found Delilah instead. It was all highways and graveyards after that. Never looking back. Vice Overseer Byrne is an ambitious man, but he believes in the Abbey's mission. Protecting the good people of the Empire against the likes of us. You know he'd be happier deep down if this ended with Brianna Ashworth's head on a spike. Maybe yours as well.
Missing a day before he did, and someone found an officer's pistol in the gutter.
No matter how many of you I have to sacrifice, we're going to fight for Delilah.
Look, Karnak is leaking people. We tell ourselves we're keeping it together, but everyone is afraid of what will happen when it really falls apart.
number of mine workers, and he did it. No questions, no complaints. We're not gonna need it, miners, and you can do the same. Out of thin air! That's the Chicago experience.
Getting so one can't even breathe no more.
Somewhere inside the Royal Conservatory.
Tasted awful. That weren't no blue-jawed hagfish.
Thank you.
to find out how a sword through the heart wasn't enough to kill our new Empress Delilah.
Brianna to make an effigy of me.
You mean like this tangle of skin and bone representing one of the Dunderheads from the Oracular Order?
Yes, I'd keep it
in my chambers.
You have bizarre taste, my...
I'd keep it in my chambers.
You have bizarre taste, my dude. Clarissa, I wouldn't want to see myself like that. I'd rather have my portrait painted by Delilah.
There's a... quality to Brianna's style I prefer. Touched by something from deep down in the mud, where there's no light. The endless womb and the cold, dead grave.
But Brianna's effigy is let her reach into the mind, into the heart. Wouldn't you?
You're not.
Into the heart. Wouldn't you be afraid she'd influence your dreams? Like she's going to do to you?
I'll be damned. What? I won't let her escape!
Thank you. influence your dreams, like she's going to do to the Sisters of the Abbey?
That's part of the thrill, sister.
Jindosh was tiresome. How does this even work?
Who is this man carrying Jindosh? And what power does he hold over Brianna? Are they lovers?
Perhaps, but that wouldn't give him any power over Brianna. Jindosh is an ally, an agent of the Duke. Gifted in the ways of natural philosophy. Together, they've built something that can pierce the void itself.
I've never seen Brianna work with machines. She's always relied on precious bones.
Thank you. Would I even be in this situation if you'd lived? Ashworth is influencing the Oracular Order.
I meant nothing to my fine family. Beyond an advantageous marriage and years of childbearing, they promised me to a man three times my age who wheezed on about
I still have the old lenses and cast-off parts piled in my workshop, but Jindosh finished some time ago. The rest is up to me, learning to use a machine. A tricky thing. Touching the void through such a device.
Blood and biscuits. I look forward to using it myself once you're ready.
Will you visit soon?
Perhaps. Dunwall Tower is most...
The High Overseer won't be a problem anymore.
Then there's the matter of my own project. I grow more excited with each brushstroke. When I come to Karnaca, we'll drink an ocean of good wine and stay tight as a boiled owl. Child, born into a silk-padded cradle, you will never understand what she meant to me.
Ashworth's journal might tell me more about why Delilah can't be killed.
locks open.
Nonsense.
They keep the curious away.
Our mistress likes them where they are, so you'll have to tolerate them.
Yes, but sometimes they want to smash them into a bloody pulp just to enjoy the silence.
Is this a riddle? We're talking about the Grand Guard, right?
Of course, the blood flies adore us. We should find more of them dead so they can make new nests.
Then I agree. But dear Brianna wants us to wait until after the communion, until she's finished with the oracular sisters. We can't risk raising suspicion now.
Then for now we'll wait, content with the nests we have.
This is a fine mess, Matthias.
Delilah fell to the assassin Dowd. Her magic was lost, and the coven scattered. I made a new life in Karnaca. Then I heard her whispering from the void, leading me to the Duke, who heard those same whispers. Together we worked to bring Delilah back into the world, changing the Empire from the home of Aramis Stilton 3 years ago. Across the aisles, all of us who'd been with her at Brigmore and before, we felt the magic return. Others joined. New faces, new blood. Now, Delilah is immortal. Forever. She holds Dunwall, and we've turned to corrupting the oracular order. The overseers take guidance from their prophetic sisters, and soon we'll influence their dreams and visions.
Always the one who has to gather moss under a full moon.
If I eat it, no, wait. No, if he eats it. And then what? I hope they accept my transfer. I've got to get over to one of the other districts.
What a pleasant surprise to see.
Welcome back. I see you found the prototype.
Your acquaintance didn't make it.
It is a risky line of work, I'm afraid, but let's not dwell. I expect you'll be interested in payment. First, your finder's fee, of course, and if you like, I can draw up some schematics based on the prototype, something you can use to modify your tools. And as a token of my appreciation, a discount at the shop.
A fair deal.
What a pleasant surprise to see you again. This is what I have for upgrading your equipment. And do think of us again.
Make the next death.
saw someone right here. Let's check the place just in case.
So it's done.
Ashworth won't be a problem anymore.
Good. But Emily, there's something else. Back when I lived in Dunwall, I did things that I'm not proud of.
Isn't that a requirement for citizenship?
What I've got to say is not a joke. I knew Delilah and Ashworth. Bought into their bullshit. Which led me down a bad road. To be honest, before all this, I thought Delilah dead. I don't want to get into it right now. But I felt like you should know. There are things I regret.
You never know who to trust, do you?
Everybody makes mistakes, Empress. You'll have to tell me all your secrets someday. Are you ready to leave now?
Yes, let's go. Take me back to the Dreadful Whale.
Another step toward the Duke of Cirkonos and Delilah.
For several years, Delilah's been here, getting stronger, turning people against me. Why didn't I see it coming? What was I doing during that time? Pretending to listen at court, ruling through an army of bureaucrats, waiting for the next chance to get free of Dunwall Tower. Well, now I'm free. If only I could go back. Aramis Stilton was once an ally of the Duke. The owner of Karnaca's mines, Stilton lives in a fortified bunker at the heart of the Dust District. No one's seen him for years, since around the time Delilah started making her moves. But whether Stilton's alive or dead, his home holds the key to Delilah's immortality.